Ready?
All right,
ladies and gentlemen, let me welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Dan Sloan. I'm a former director of the club. For those directly attending here, kindly put your cell phones on manner mode. Those in the room, please keep your mask on. I will do the same, excuse me, or I think I'm supposed to keep it off as I speak. But for the duration of the news conference, for our guests online, please send your questions to our speaker on our webpage link. We'll try to get everyone over the next hour. We meet today on July 30th, 2021, while parts of Japan remain in a state of emergency due to the pandemic, although the Olympic Games are underway in Tokyo and other prefectures, including the home of our guest today, Governor Yuji Kuroiwa. Okay. Kanagawa, his prefecture, and my hometown in Yokohama, is second in Japan in population. The Ken is currently hosting a number of Olympic sports that include soccer, sailing, softball, and baseball. On the other hand, Kanagawa, like Tokyo, has seen the number of COVID cases rise dramatically. As reports go, yesterday was 1,164. That is a record. Understanding for the Ken, excuse me. The understanding is a new state of emergency that encompasses Kanagawa, Osaka, Saitama, Chiba will be in effect from Monday until the end of August, as these prefectures join Tokyo and Okinawa in a either existing or harsher lockdown. With games in full swing, meaning Olympic Games, it's important to note that the daily case total for Japan exceeded 10,000 cases yesterday. That means over 10% were in Kanagawa. This is the second straight day of unfortunate and hopefully non-repeated record numbers. Governor Kuroiwa says the medical system in Kanagawa is on the verge of collapse. And we will hear more about what this means for prefectural infrastructure and preparation shortly. By way of background, our guest actually comes from our ranks as a journalist. He joined Fuji TV in 1980 and became a very successful anchor. He left ultimately to become governor of the prefecture of Kanagawa in April 2011. As I just told him, we met briefly that year for a story about electric vehicles, and we are very honored to welcome him here to the FCCJ, albeit virtually, to share with us the gravity of this pandemic crisis as it affects Kanagawa and all of Japan, and why, if things really are so dangerous and catastrophic, or potentially catastrophic, that the games will continue regardless. With no further ado, Governor Kuroiwa, thank you very much.
Good
evening, everybody. As introduced now, I am the governor of Kanagawa Prefecture. My name is Yuji Kuroiwa. Thank you very much for creating the opportunity today.
2014年、今から7年前、そちらにお伺いしてスピーチをする機会をいただきました。
I had the opportunity to visit the club actually 7 years ago in 2014 to give a speech then.
その時は神奈川が取り組むこのヘルスケアニューフロンティアという取り組みをご説明させていただきました。
And at that time, I spoke about the Kanagawa Prefecture's Healthcare New Frontier Program.
今回はこのコロナ禍におオリンピックという非常にタイムリーなテーマでの話となりました。
And today we are, of course, speaking about the Olympics taking place under the COVID-19 pandemic, which is a very timely issue.
私はもともとテレビキャスター、ジャーナリストでありましたから、実は皆さんにお伺いしたい気持ちの方が強いですね。
I'm originally, as introduced, a television anchor and also a journalist, so there's actually a lot that I would like to ask of all of you.
これだけコロナが感染して緊急事態宣言が出ているという、そういう中でオリンピックをやっているということを 世界の皆さんはどんなふうに見てるのかといったことは知りたいですね。
I would like to know about amid this COVID-19 situation, which is continuing to expand, and also during the state of emergency, how the fact that Japan is indeed holding the Olympics at the moment is viewed by people around the world.
我々はこのコロナの中でオリンピック1年延期せざるを得なくなりました。
We had to, of course, postpone these Olympic Games for 1 year due to the COVID-19 situation.
その時は1年延期したオリンピックは絶対もコロナが収束している、そういう中で行われるために1年延期したというふうにみんな信じていました。
And at that time, of course, we believed that after postponing the games for 1 year, then the COVID-19 situation would have been contained by this time.
それがまさかこの緊急事態宣言、この今日もですね、昨日も、コロナの患者数は新記録を作っていますけども、そんな中で東京オリンピックっていうのは最も避けたかったシナリオでした。
And of course, the scenario that we are now facing, which is indeed the Olympic Games taking place under the situation which we had not imagined at the time, in the middle of the state of emergency and with record numbers of COVID-19 cases being recorded both yesterday and today.
もう国もそして我々のような地方自治体もみんな一丸となって避けよう避けようとしたシナリオにそのまま突入していったということ自体、 このコロナとの戦いがいかに難しいかを表しているというふうに思います。
And the fact that, of course, all of the regional governments of Japan together with the national government were working together to do all that we could to avoid this scenario. But the fact that we have now entered this as a reality, I think, demonstrates just how difficult this struggle against the COVID-19 pandemic is.
神奈川県ではですね、セーリング、そして野球、ソフトボール、サッカー、そして自転車、ロードレース、 この 競技が 行われます。
In Kanagawa Prefecture, the competitions of sailing, baseball, softball, and also the soccer and the road cycling are taking place.
もともとはですね、東京オリンピックが決定した時には、すべての競技を東京都でやるといったことでなっていました。
Originally, when the games were decided to be held in Tokyo, all of the competitions were scheduled to take place within only Tokyo.
ところがですね、あまりにも費用負担が大きすぎるといったことで、東京都以外でも開催しようという話になりました。
However, due to the fact that the budget implications would be so large for Tokyo only, there was moves then or developments to hold competitions also in other prefectures throughout Japan.
それならば我々にもチャンスがあるんだといったことでですね、私も全力を挙げてその競技の誘致励んできました。
So we saw then that Kanagawa also had a chance in this, and so I put all of my efforts towards the bid to bring some of the sports to Kanagawa.
まずはセーリング。これ57年前の東京オリンピックの時にもですね、セーリングは江ノ島、この神奈川の江ノ島で開かれました。
And first, in regards to sailing, of course, during the Tokyo Olympics, which were held 57 years ago, the sailing competition was also held at 江ノ島.
この江ノ島で行われるセーリングはですね、富士山を見ながらこのセーリング競技ができるという最高の場所であります。
江ノ島 is of course an ideal location to have these sailing competitions as you are able to sail while also gazing upon Mount Fuji.
ですからこれは多分簡単にその我々は招致を決められるもんだというふうに最初は思っていました。
So at first I thought that it was, you know, quite a straightforward thing, a simple thing that we could be bidding and deciding to have these games taking place in Kanagawa.
しかし、日本セーリング協会がですね、東京都でやりたいという気持ちが非常に強くてですね、それと全面衝突になりました。
However, the Japan Sailing Association was very insistent upon the fact that they actually wanted the sailing to take place in Tokyo, and we really came head to head with them about this.
我々もありとらゆる手を使ってですね、なんとかして江ノ島に持ってこようとして、やっと最後に勝ち取ることができました。
We used all of the different means that we had available to make our efforts to bring the sailing to Kanagawa, and in the end, we were successful in this.
そして、そのためにですね、江ノ島に渡るこの橋があるんですけども、ここがいつも渋滞するといったことで、それを拡充するという工事も行いました。
And then once it was decided that they would take place in Enoshima, there is a bridge which goes to the island, which is always very congested. So we even went to the extent of expanding or having construction to make this larger.
それともに江ノ島にはですね、もともとセーリングを楽しむ方のボートが1000艇近くあります。
And originally there are also around 1,000 boats which are anchored at Enoshima by people who are enjoying sailing.
これをその大会を実施するために全部の船をですね、一回その別のところに移動していただくということをやらなきゃいけなかったですね。
And in order to create the space for the sailing competition to take place, we had to relocate all of these boats to a different place.
一人一人その、船を持ってらっしゃる方にお話をして、そして了承いただいて移動するという作業は大変でした。
And the work to go one by one to each of the different owners of these boats and ask for their support and gain their consent was a very great undertaking.
そして全部移動し終わった時に1年延期が決まりました。
And just when the relocation of all of these boats works was complete was when the one-year postponement was decided.
そしてまたその船を全部元に戻してですね。そしてまた1年経ってまた移動してというこういった作業を我々はやりました。
So after the postponement was decided, we then had to bring all of these boats back to Enoshima, and then 1 year later, once the games were about to take place, do this all over again. So there was a lot of work which went into this.
それとそのセーリングが行われる海はですね、漁業者が漁をしている海域ともぶつかります。
And the area where the sailing is taking place is also an area which local fishermen are using as well, and so there is also this issue of how to use this, this ocean space.
ですから漁業関係者とこのエリアでやるんだと、このエリアでやるんだという細かい、作業をしてですね、協力を得る努力をしてまいりました。
We had to therefore speak with the different people involved in the fishing industry to ensure that this is the very specific area which will be used for the sailing and go through detailed explanations and consultations with them.
そしてさらにそのセーリングのオリンピックを成功させるためにワールドカップですね、これ3年連続その江ノ島でやるといったことも実施してきました。
Also, further to ensure the success of the sailing Olympic, the sailing in the Olympics, we also held the sailing World Cup in Enoshima in 3 years in a row.
そういった意味で完璧な形の準備が出てきていました。
So this meant that we had really the perfect preparations in place.
これは他の競技でもそうで、野球を行う、野球とソフトボールを行う横浜スタジアム、これはですね、客席をオリンピック用に増設をしました。
The same can be said for the other competitions also confirmed to take place in Yokohama. For example, the Yokohama Stadium where the baseball and the softball is taking place, we went through efforts to expand the number of seats there so that it could fit the Olympic standards.
実はこのオリンピックの1年前にラグビーワールドカップが行われました。
And also 1 year before the Olympics were scheduled was when the World Rugby Cup was held.
これは神奈川県と横浜市でタッグを組んで、そして、ラグビーワールドカップのメインスタジアムを横浜に持ってきました。
The city of Yokohama and the prefectural government of Kanagawa collaborated together to bring the main stadium to Yokohama.
これは最高の大会になってですね、この世界のラグビー協会の会長からも、これまでのワールドカップの中で最高の試合大会だったというお褒めの言葉もいただきました。
This was a great success, and it led to even statements by the World Rugby Chairman that indeed the 2019 Rugby World Cup in Japan in Kanagawa was the greatest World Cup to have been held.
その流れを組んで、我々この神奈川で行われるオリンピックの競技もですね、最高のオリンピックにしようと盛り上がってきたところでありました。
And so these were the different efforts which were taking place in the background to ensure that the Olympic Games, and particularly held in Kanagawa, would be the greatest to take place.
しかし、このオリンピックが近づくにつれてですね、コロナの感染者の数が全然減らないという状況になってまいりました。
However, as we came closer to the date of the Olympics, of course, we had the situation where the number of COVID-19 cases was not decreasing at all.
実はですね、このコロナとの戦いというものは神奈川県にとって、去年の2月にですね、ダイヤモンド・プリンセス号という大きな客船が横浜港に着くといったところから始まりました。
Of course, our struggle against the COVID-19, the virus as Kanagawa Prefecture began from February last year when the Diamond Princess, the large cruise liner, docked in Yokohama.
3,700 人もの乗った客船が突然着いて、その中にコロナの患者がいるということが分かりました。
And of course, from there, there were 3,700 people on board this cruise liner, which suddenly docked in Yokohama, including also COVID-19 patients.
最初陽性患者10人だというふうに報告を受けました。
At first we heard that there were 10 positive cases on board.
3,700 人のうちの10人かと最初は思いましたが、そうではなくて、検査の結果が分かったのが30人のうちの10人が陽性者だと分かりました。
So we were of the understanding that it was 10 out of the 3,700 people on board who were indeed positive cases. However, we found out later that this was 10 of the 30 who had been tested. And so it was a very different figure than we found out.
新型コロナウイルスがどういう病気かまだわからないときにですね、突然それだけのもしかしたら1000人もの患者がいるかもしれない患者を我々は、受け入れを担うことになりました。
And at that stage, of course, we were not aware. No one was aware about what kind of virus COVID-19 was. And we were all of a sudden faced with the situation that perhaps we would have to take on 1,000 even COVID-19 patients.
結果的には700人を超える患者がいたのですが、それを全部下ろしてですね、そしてその様々な病院に搬送するという業務を担いました。
In the end, there were around 700 COVID-19 positive cases on board. All of those, of course, had to be disembarked and then transferred to different medical facilities.
その時にですね、重症患者、中等症患者、軽症無症状、この3段階に分けて搬送するというモデルを作りました。
And at that time, we created a model for transferring the patients based on three different categories, including those who had serious, mid to light, or no symptoms.
その時一番目指したことはですね、このコロナ患者に対応するといったことと同時に、医療を崩壊させないといったことでした。
What we were aiming for as the greatest objective at that time, of course, as well as treating and responding to the patients, but also ensuring that we could prevent a medical collapse.
我々が初めて直面したコロナの患者、軽症無症状の人がたくさんいるといった現実がありました。
And when we first came face to face with the COVID-19 situation, we saw that there were many cases of patients who had either no or light symptoms.
ウイルスをたくさん持っているのに症状が出てない人がたくさんいるといったことは大変な驚きでした。
So we were very surprised to learn of this situation that there were many people who were carrying the virus, however, had no symptoms.
日本の感染症法上は無症状であってもそういう陽性患者は全員指定の医療機関に送るといったことになっていました。
And under Japanese law for infectious diseases, it meant that all people who had been diagnosed as having an infectious disease, even if they were displaying no symptoms, had to be transferred to specific designated medical facilities.
その通りやっていれば、もうあっという間に日本の医療は崩壊していました。
If that had been done at the time, then in an instant, the Japanese medical system would have collapsed.
我々は軽症無症状の人は病院ではなくて自宅あるいはホテル等にですね収容するというモデルを作りました。
Therefore, we created a model for people with light or no symptoms to be either remaining at home or in hotels for their treatment or for their situation.
これがコロナ提供体制神奈川モデルといったことで今全国に広がっています。
And this is what is now known as the Kanagawa model and which has been expanded to be implemented throughout all of Japan.
そういう中でこれまでのずっと長い戦いの中で医療はなんとか守ってくることができました。
So throughout this very long struggle, we have somehow managed to maintain the medical system within these circumstances.
しかしこのオリンピックを前にしてですね、感染者の数が収まりきらないという状況の中で、オリンピックを中止しろといった声まで出てきました。
However, as we approached the holding of the Olympic Games, as there was a situation where the COVID-19 was not coming under containment, there started to be voices calling for the cancellation of the Games.
私はとにかくこのオリンピックというものはですね、アスリートの皆さんがその日を夢見て一生懸命頑張ってきた、その晴れの舞台、なんとかしてそれを守り通してあげたいという気持ちが強かったです。
I felt very strongly that thinking about the situation of the athletes who had been dreaming of that day, dedicating, making all of their efforts towards that day, wanting to somehow make it a reality for them.
本来ならそのアスリートのひたむきな姿、それを多くの感染者が、観客が見守り、感動し、その感動が全世界に発信していくという、まあ、これがオリンピックだというふうに受け止めていました。
Of course, in an ideal situation, and what is really the heart of the Olympics would be for these efforts of the athletes and their achievements on the day to be seen by many different spectators in person, and for them to be very moved by this, and these emotions to be shared with the world.
この1年延期しただけでもアスリートの皆さんにとっては大変な負担だったというふうに思います。
However, I believe that this one-year postponement, even that, was indeed a great burden on the athletes.
それをこのコロナの感染者が増えたことによって中止するというのはあまりにも冷たい決断だというふうに私は思いました。
So I personally thought that to cancel the games in completion or in total, even because of a result of this increase in the COVID cases, would be something which would be really too much of a cold estimate.
そのためにいろんなこの周りの要素を全部諦めることにしました。
Therefore, we decided to give up on a lot of the things surrounding the actual competitions themselves.
まずは聖火リレー、この公道で走る聖火リレーは中止をしました。
First of all, was the decision to cancel the torch relay running on public roads.
そしてトーチキスというこの走らないでですね、トーチキスだけをやっていくというイベントに変えました。
Therefore, we changed to an event which did not include the running, but just had what was known as the torch kiss, so just a static event.
それともにこの神奈川県内で行われるオリンピックの試合のお客様をゼロにするといったことにしました。
Then we made the decision to have zero spectators for all of the games to be held in Kanagawa Prefecture.
それは私にとっても非常に辛い決断でありました。
This was an extremely difficult decision for me to make.
オリンピックを事前にもっともっとこの盛り上げていこうと思っていましたが、それも全部できなくなりました。
Of course, we wanted to create more excitement, more of an atmosphere around these Olympic Games. However, none of this was possible.
で、私はずっと信じてたことがあります。それはオリンピックが実際始まってみれば、この選手たちのこの活躍によってきっと盛り上がるに違いないと、そう思っていました。
However, throughout this entire period, I held the strong belief that once the Olympics start, then people will indeed be greatly encouraged or moved by the efforts of the athletes.
今オリンピックが始まって1週間ですけど、私の思った通りになりました。
It is now 1 week since the Tokyo Olympic Games have started, and exactly what I had hoped is indeed now the case.
日本人の大活躍によってですね、日本選手の大活躍によって、もう日本中は今オリンピック毎日毎日みんな感動の嵐が吹き荒れています。
Thanks to the great achievements of the Japanese athletes, the whole of Japan now is being moved on a daily basis by everything that is happening.
ところが、この感染者の数がこの最近になって激増しています。
However, at the same time, in recent days, we are seeing a dramatic increase in the number of COVID-19 cases.
神奈川県もこの今日も含めて毎日1000人を超えるという勢いで記録を更新し続けています。
神奈川 prefecture also is having new records on a daily basis with the several days, including today, also having more than 1,000 cases.
これワクチンを打つといったことはこの地方自治体の仕事ですけども、これを今一生懸命やっていますが、あと2ヶ月早ければといった思いが非常に強いです。
At the moment, of course, the vaccination is the responsibility of the different local governments and the prefectural governments, and we are putting all efforts in place into this at the moment. And I very much feel that if only this had been 2 months faster.
まずはこの7月までに65歳以上の老人、希望する人を全部打ち切るといった目標を作ってきましたが、これは達成できています。
First of all, we had the goal to, by the end of this July, to have all those people over the age of 65 who wish to be vaccinated complete, and this has been achieved.
そのことによってですね、この重症病棟の、占有率が比較的軽く進んでいます。
And as or thanks to that, we are seeing the situation that the number of people with serious symptoms and those being hospitalized is much fewer.
しかし、この感染者の急増、しかも最近は若い人がどんどん感染するといった状況になっていて、このまま続けば医療が崩壊する危険性というのは十分出てきました。
However, if we continue to see the rise in the number of COVID cases as we are experiencing at the moment, and particularly lately seeing an increase in the number of young people, then we will be facing the serious risk of medical collapse.
実は今日ですね、国の方で我々の神奈川県も含めて緊急事態宣言といったことを出すといったことを受けて、この後ですね、我々は対策本部会議を開きます。
So actually today the Japanese national government made the decision to include Kanagawa prefecture also within the state of emergency, and following this press conference we will also be having a meeting in regards to this.
その中で最後に私は県民に向けてのメッセージを出します。
So I would like to close my speech today finally with a message to the people of Kanagawa prefecture.
今の状況が続けば、この救急車で病院に行こうと思っても行けなくなる、それだけの危機的な状況が来てるんだといった思いを皆さんに伝えたいと思っています。
I would like to convey the fact to everybody that the situation now is so serious that we may soon be seeing the situation where even if you want to go to hospital by ambulance, this might not even be possible.
日本の場合にはこのロックダウンという厳しい措置ができない中で要請要請外出を自粛してくださいと要請しかできなかった。
The fact that in Japan a strict lockdown is not possible means that we are limited to only making requests or asking people to refrain from doing certain things.
こういったことがずっと続いてきたことによってですね、もうみんなもう聞いてられないという我慢できないというそんな特に若い人はそういう気持ちになっています。
And due to this situation being prolonged for such a long period of time now, I think that many people, especially young people, are feeling that, well, they just cannot continue doing this. They cannot really keep bearing this in this way.
しかし皆さんの行動変容に訴えかけるしかこれを乗り越える道はありません。
However, the only way that we can overcome this situation is by appealing to you in regards to your action and behavior.
私たちは何としてもですね、この感染者をギリギリ抑えながら、そしてその医療崩壊を防ぎながら、このオリンピック最後まで成し遂げたいと考えています。
We hope that somehow through to our joint efforts, we can keep the virus contained enough that we can prevent medical collapse and see the Olympics through to their conclusion.
それともにその後に控えているパラリンピック、これもですね、障害者の皆さんがたくさんいらっしゃるわけですから、これまで以上に配慮が必要かもしれないと思います。
And following the Olympic Games, there are of course also the Paralympics scheduled to be held. This includes also the participation of many persons with disabilities, so perhaps calls for even more consideration.
これも何とかして成功させるためにですね、我々は全力を注いでいきたいと考えています。
In order to make these Paralympics also a success, we intend to put all of our efforts possible towards this goal.
私からまずはこういうお話をさせていただきました。ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Governor Kuroiwa. Just for both our online audience and those here, the governor has a very tight schedule today, and we have a very hard stop at 5:45. We have 19 minutes for question and answer. So let's get on with it. Sir, please identify yourself, your affiliation, and please limit yourself in the interest of time to one question and no speeches.
ではこれで仕事に入ります。今日は45分ちょうどに終わりたいと思います。早速お願いします。
知事、インドネシアのメディア、トリビューニュース、シロと申します。神奈川はものすごい大好きなんですけれども、まあそれはどうでもいいですけれども、3月緊急事態宣言の時が江ノ島行きました。でその時がものすごい混んでるので、で今もずっと混んでるので、そこの辺で、まあ、箱根も含めていろいろ観光のところ、で今の緊急事態宣言起きても聞かないじゃないですか、みんな。それを例えば厳しく法律を厳しく、させれば、いかがでしょうか。例えばお店が、8時過ぎたら、罰金50万円だったら、まあ、大体いろいろそんな罰金に含めて出したらいかがですか、知事。よろしくお願いします。
My name is Cecilia of the Indonesian Media Tribune News. I very much like Kanagawa Prefecture. However, I would like to say that when I visited in March during the state of emergency, Enoshima, for example, was very crowded at the time and it continues to be today. I would like to ask, will people actually listen when another state of emergency is declared? And are there efforts, for example, that could be considered for a stricter enforcement of this? For example, having a fine of 500,000 Japanese yen for shops who remain open after 8 p.m.
今の大変素晴らしい質問だと思いますね。
I think that's a very good question.
日本のその国のあり方の本質をついている問題だというふうに私は思っています。
And I think that it touches on one of the fundamental aspects of Japan.
海外を見ているとですね、このロックダウンするともう街の中に誰もいなくなって、街を歩いていると警察に連れてかれます。
In many countries overseas, as we're watching the situation, we're seeing very tight lockdowns and places where there's nobody walking around on the streets, or if people are, they might be taken by the police, for example.
しかし日本の場合にはそういった強権的なことに対する反発は非常に強くてですね、この我々ガバナーとしていえども、皆さんにお願いすることしかできないんです。
However, in Japan, there is a lot of opposition to these kind of measures. So as a governor, the method that we have available is to ask or request people to cooperate.
このお店の方もですね、飲食店の方もここで感染が広がる危険性が高いといったことで海外では全部休業させています。
For example, looking at restaurants, these are places where there is a high risk of contagion. And so we look at the situation in other countries, and many of them are being asked to close down during the period. However, in replacement for that, or in exchange for that, very strong subsidies or financial support is in place.
ですが、日本の場合にはこれもですね、要請するしかできなくて、そしてまあ協力金をお支払いするという形しかできない。
However, in the case of Japan, the method that we have available is to make requests of such establishments and to provide cooperation funds for those who cooperate.
まあ、こういうことが続いてくるとですね、もう皆さん何度も何度も同じことを要請されるので、もう聞いてられないという気持ちになっていますね。
However, within such a situation, of course, we have when this is repeated several times, people feel that as it happens again and again, they're not able to continue to go along with this.
日本の一番大きな問題は、平時と有事、この 区別がさっきしっかりついていないことだと私は思っています。
And I think that the biggest issue here in Japan is that there is not this clear distinction between the times of emergency and non-emergency.
今は火事が燃え盛ってる最中ですから、そういった崩壊をいきなりすることはできません。
And now at the moment we are in the time of course where the flames are burning really, where the fire is blazing at the moment. So looking at this kind of creating new legal systems in place is not something to be done in this short term.
このコロナが収束した上ではですね、日本の国、平時と有事、特にパンデミックっていうキーワードの中で平時と有事をどう切り分けて、どういう法体系を作るかといったことは大きな課題になってくると私は思っています。
However, I believe that after the COVID-19 situation has been contained, having new or looking at what kind of legislation needs to be in place in Japan in order to have this clear determination between the emergency and non-emergency times, and particularly in times of pandemic, is something which will be necessary.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Next question, please.
お忙しい中ありがとうございます。ラジオフランス、とリベラション新聞の特派員西村と申します。2点お願いします。多くの政治家、まあ総理大臣をはじめ多くの政治家、あるいは東京都知事、または東京組織、東京2020組織委員会の橋本会長は、 安心安全な大会と言い続けてるんですけれども、今の状況を見たら安心安全な大会と言えるのでしょうか。それは1点目です。2点目はどちらにするか。まあ、まずこちらお願いします。
So the first question, my name is Nishimura from Radio France and Libre newspaper. The first question is many people, including, of course, many politicians, the Prime Minister of Japan, Tokyo Governor, and Ms. Hashimoto of the Olympic Organizing Committee are saying that we will be having a safe and secure games. I would like to ask your opinion as to whether we can say the current situation is safe and secure.
これも非常に難しい問題だと思いますが、逆に皆さんがどう思われているか私には大きな関心がありますね。
So this is indeed a very difficult question, and I'm actually very curious to know about what your perspectives as the foreign press are in regards to this.
これだけ感染者が新記録、新記録をなっている中で、オリンピックをやっているということ、これが安全安心な大会であるかというのは大変疑問だと思われても仕方がないと思います。
And I think that it is unavoidable for you to consider or to have questions about indeed whether it is possible to have and whether we are having safe and secure games under the situation where there are new COVID-19 records being announced every day. However, we are in the position that our responsibility is to aim for safe and secure games within these current conditions.
このリスクをできるだけ低くするといったことについて全力を挙げてきました。
We have put all of our efforts towards minimizing this risk as much as possible.
実は神奈川県から提案をしてですね、組織委員会とずっと協議会を設けてきました。
So actually the Kanagawa Prefecture made a proposal and we have had a constant or a standing joint council with the organizing committee.
これは大会のために海外から来られる様々な関係者の皆さん、選手も含めて、それをいわゆるバブル方式といった形でですね、皆さんと接触、他の人と接触しないようにして、この送り届けるといったことによって安全安心を確保しようというのが組織委員会の考えでした。
And the stance which was expressed by the organizing committee within this joint council was looking at how to create a bubble between those people who are coming to Japan for the games from overseas, including the athletes, to ensure that they are not coming into contact with other persons.
我々は現場を預かる立場としてそのバブル今のままでは緩いと言ったことでですね、様々な提案をしながらバブルを完璧なものにするために様々な提案をしてきました。
And throughout the preparatory proceedings and as we are going today as well, we have been looking at the plans which are in place from the situation of actually what would be happening on site, looking for the different loose areas within this bubble and looking at how we can make it a more complete and more safe and secure situation.
海外から来られる人が、万を超える人たちがやってくる中でですね、感染者をゼロにすることは、これは不可能です。
When we consider the situation that there are tens of thousands of people coming to Japan from overseas, then it is impossible to have zero cases.
我々は何人ぐらい感染者が出るのか、その人たちをどのようにして対応するのか、そしてそれを一般の県民、国民と触れ合わないようにするためにはどうすればいいか、それを検討してきました。
Therefore, what we were considering is looking at how to make different estimates or simulations about how many cases we might be dealing with, looking at how to respond to that situation and how we could ensure that they would not be coming into contact with the citizens of the prefecture or the country.
実は神奈川県の場合にですね、これまで、海外から来られた方でですね、オリンピック関係者で感染者はゼロです。
In the case of Kanagawa Prefecture, we have actually had zero cases of people who have come to Japan for the games being found to be positive for COVID-19.
我々のシミュレーションで出した数字よりもはるかに下回っています。
This is actually less than the simulation that we had prepared in advance.
ちなみに東京都もですね、これ1日あたり今 4.5 人、陽性患者出てるんですけども、想定したのはですね、7.7 人でした。
In the case of Tokyo as well, the current situation is that 4.5 people are being found to be positive on a daily basis, but the prior estimates was actually 7.7.
ですから、まあ、陽性患者を想定した中では、我々は低く抑えられているという状況にはあります。
Therefore, this shows that we have been able to contain to a lower amount the number of positive cases than had been estimated in regards to those personnel coming from overseas involved with the games.
こういう中でこの感染爆発を起こさないようにしながらですね、なんとかしてこの期間を乗り越えてきて安全安心の大会だったなと言われるように我々努力したいと思っています。
Therefore, we want to continue to make efforts to prevent an explosion of cases and to try and keep this as low as possible to ensure that we can hold as close as possible to a safe and secure games.
You have a second one?
2点目。その開会、まあ、大会を開催することについて議論あったのかどうかを知りたいんです。つまりその是非についてあったかどうか、それは外国人からすると一番不思議なことです。
And the second question is, I would like to ask whether there was actually debate over whether the Olympics should go ahead or not, whether they should be held or not. This is perhaps the point which is, or appears most peculiar from a perspective from overseas.
これを大会するかどうかについての議論というのは確かにありました。しかしこれを決めるのはですね、五者協議の場でありました。
There was indeed discussion or debate about whether the games should go forward or not. However, the decision to be made within this is between the conference of the five parties.
我々は開催自治体ですから、そこで決まった内容を実現するといったことは我々の使命でありました。
And our responsibility, our mission as the local government of one of the host areas was to look at how we realize or how we implement what has been decided at that level.
しかし、日本国内で本当にその開催すべきかどうかの議論が真剣に行われたかどうかといったこと、これはなかなか難しい質問だというふうに思いますね。
However, as to whether there really was serious discussion, serious debate about whether the Olympics should go on, should go ahead or not within Japan, I think that is a good question.
ただ私は、まあ、さっき言いましたように、アスリートが活躍できる場を最低限作ったといったことではよかったなというふうには思っています。
However, personally, I believe the fact that we were able to create this space for the athletes to do their best, is something that I'm very glad that we did.
今この、ツイッター等もですね、最初はネガティブな人が多かったですけども、実際始まってみるとですね、肯定的に開催をし、支持する人の数がどんどん増えてきているというのが現状ですね。
And if we look at, for example, the comments being made on Twitter prior to the starting of the Olympic Games, the majority of the comments and so on were very negative about them being held. However, now that the Olympics have actually started, this has shifted to a higher number of positive comments or people being supportive of the Games.
最終的に開催してよかったなとみんなが思うような大会にですね、するために全力を挙げていきたいと思っています。
So I hope that we will continue all of our efforts to ensure that everybody will eventually be able to feel that they are glad that the Olympics did take place.
Governor, I'll take the opportunity to ask the next question. Looking at the previous global sporting events that Japan has held, in particular the 2002 World Cup, some communities like Oita prefectures are still paying for stadiums that they built to support the event. Obviously, you were indicating that you campaigned to actually have Kanagawa host some of these events, probably with the assumption that there would be fans and there would be, you know, impact, positive economic impact for the communities that hosted them. And now there are no fans at all. Can you tell us a bit about, you know, if there are economic models existent, what kind of losses potentially economically, you know, we want to be respectful of the, you know, the health circumstances, of course, but you're a government and you work on taxpayer money. What kind of losses are likely via having no fans at the events that Kanagawa is hosting?
司会の方から一つ質問させていただきます。過去にですね、日本で開催されたあの、まあ、例えば2002年のワールドカップなどなんですけれども、まあ、例えばあの大分県などが今でもその時に作られたスタジアムの費用を今でも払い続けているというような状況があると思います。まあ、今回も神奈川県の方からあの積極的に誘致をしたということがあったというふうにおっしゃったんですけれども、まあ、それをおそらく観客が来ることによってあの、まあ、ポジティブな経済効果もあの、まあ、あの予測できる期待できるということがあったのではないかと思います。しかし今回は無観客で開催するということになってしまったことによって、神奈川県としてはどのような経済的な損失というものを予想されているのでしょうか。もちろんまあその無観客にするということは様々な医療のこと、あの保険のことなどを考えての決定だったと思うんですけれども、その経済効果そして損失の方についてお願いいたします。
はい、ありがとうございます。神奈川県の場合にはですね、このオリンピックのために特別なこの大きな施設を作ったというのはあまりありません。
First of all, in the case of Kanagawa Prefecture, we did not have the case of setting up any new infrastructure or facilities and so on for the purpose of the Olympics.
唯一セーリングセンターというものを作りましたけども、あとは先ほど申し上げた江ノ島に渡る橋を拡充したといったことでありました。
The only things which were done was, first of all, the creation of a sailing center and the expansion of the bridge to Enoshima, as mentioned.
これはですね、オリンピックが終わってもずっと使える、ものでありますから、これ経済的に損失にはなっていないというふうに思います。
And these are, of course, things which will continue to be in use after the games have closed as well. Therefore, we do not see these as any kind of economic loss.
ただ、我々が期待したのは世界中からオーディエンスが来られてですね、そしてその経済効果といったものは莫大になるといったことを当然のごとく期待をいたしました。
However, of course, we did have great hopes for very large audiences to be coming to Kanagawa from all around the world and there to be a very significant economic impact from that.
特にその観光業者ですね、ホテル業界とかそれから飲食店の業界、こういったところは、期待が外れたといったことになっています。
And particularly for the tourism industry, such as hotels and restaurants and so on, of course, the expectations that were in place have unfortunately not been the case.
しかしこれはですね、この経済効果がこの大きな損失があったというわけじゃなくて、プラスがなかったといったことでありますから、致命的なその経済的なロスではなかったというふうに思っています。
However, in the case of the economic impact for Kanagawa, rather than having any large losses, it is that the positive effects that we had been hoping for did not happen. So it has not therefore been a very definitive a negative impact for us as Kanagawa.
今はその休業要請もこれからしなきゃいけないですから、こういった皆さんに対してですね、協力金をしっかり出しながら下支えしていくという中で、この難局を乗り越えてですね、その後にもう一気にこのもう一回海外からお客さんを呼んでくるっていうことに県も全力を挙げていきたいというふうに考えています。
Of course, as we are now coming forward to this next stage in dealing with the COVID-19 situation, we will be having to request different establishments to close their doors once again and provide different subsidies or cooperation funds and so on for that purpose as well. Therefore, our role now is to do all that we can to overcome this COVID-19 situation. And then once we have passed these current difficulties, then as the prefecture, we hope to make all efforts and do everything that we can to proactively bring more and more international visitors to come.
Governor, we wish you the best of hope, best of luck in these efforts as a Kanagawa resident, and just I think everyone here at the Foreign Correspondents Club. We thank you very much for your time today. We wish you good luck for the rest of the games in the weeks ahead. As is our tradition in the club, you will have a one-year honorary membership. When all states of emergency are over, we hope to welcome you here in person. Thank you very much, sir.
本日大変お忙しい中ありがとうございます。私も神奈川県民としてお礼を申し上げたいと思います。そしてこれからも大会が無事に終わること、そして今後もまた緊急事態宣言などが終わった後に直接お会いできることが、できることを楽しみにしております。で、こちらの方から1年間のメイン会員証をお渡ししますので、また状況が改善しましたら、またぜひお越しいただければと思います。本日はありがとうございました。
素晴らしい会作っていただきまして、どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. Small crowd here, but we'll clap. Yeah, thank you.